U.S. National Hurricane Center says the Dorian remains a Cat 2 hurricane and still centered about 150 miles south of Charleston and slowly approaching the Carolinas.
Hurricane warnings are in effect from central Florida all the way up through North Carolina. Millions of people remain under evacuation orders. Earlier this week, Dorian hit the Bahamas as a Category 5 storm, causing widespread devastation on some of its northern islands and leaving at least 7 people dead. And community firefighters are typically seen helping those here at home, but a few of our very own have headed east. New at 6, meteorologist Bridget Mahoney was able to talk to those on the ground in South Carolina bracing for Dorian. Bridget?
Yeah, some from the Maryland Heights Fire District and more from around the state are on the ground with Missouri Task Force 1 waiting for Dorian. Now, this storm has already brought a large scale of conditions to a large area, but no matter what else this storm brings, I think this team is ready for whatever.
Nearly any disaster that you can imagine, we have a tool for it.
Awaiting and responding to disaster, Missouri Task Force 1 is on active deployment as the coast awaits Dorian. The unit deployed to Columbia, South Carolina as the historic storm inches closer. The task force works as a support system to the communities impacted.
They get on the scene quickly when rescue operations are still taking place, and they support the local entities and support that system that's working.
Matthew Goff, rescue specialist with the Missouri Task Force 1 and a Maryland Heights firefighter, is on the ground now and ready to respond.
There is our all-terrain vehicle. So these are our boats. We have 2 John boats. This truck has a couple tanks on the rear. I mean, we carry a 72-hour pack that we are typically live out of for up to 72 hours.
It's important for the force to be self-sufficient, but even with the powerful equipment packed, the team must be equipped themselves for the task at hand.
A lot of people are multi-trained on this team. Certain individuals don't just do rescue or just do hazmat. It makes us a better team in the end when everybody's able to do everything, because we know what to expect from the next person.
There are 18 separate jobs ranging from canine search to physicians to rescue specialists and equipment operators. The task force is staffed with enough people to have 3 rotations available at a moment's notice. No matter who gets deployed or what the mission is, everyone is eager to help.
If they need evacuations, rescues, it really doesn't matter. If they ask for it to be done, we take care of it for them. No questions asked.
And that's exactly how this team operates. The team meets quarterly to work as a well-oiled team. One word that stuck out to me that Matt used was privilege, which is really a testament to how important this team is to themselves and really, more importantly, the community as a whole. Reporting live in Maryland Heights, meteorologist Bridget Mahoney, Fox 2 News.